Well, a Baltimore woman who says she was abducted as a child by a person who raised her as her own is telling her story tonight.
Monique Smith is a local missing children's advocate who helped lobby for the passing of the state's Missing Children's Act. 11 News reporter Kai Reed joins us live from the newsroom. She has the very latest on this story for us. Kai?
Well, Rondana, she goes by Symboli Monique Smith, or Monique Smith, but she says that she doesn't know what her real name is or even how old she is, but she says she'll never stop advocating for protecting kids from being abducted.
The beatings were daily. If the sun came up, if it rained, if the wind blew too hard, I was chastised.
Monique Smith describes a childhood full of abuse in a West Baltimore home with a woman she thought was her mother.
On the outside world, I looked normal. I went to school every day. I did my homework every day. I came home every day.
At age 29 in 1996, she tried to get documentation for a job. She says the paperwork came back full of inconsistencies.
Different states, different years, different date of birth. To this day, I do not know how old I am. To this day, I do not know my real name. To this day, I really feel that no one's looking for me anymore.
She says people she thought were family members admitted that her alleged mother just showed up with her one day. Then she confronted the woman who raised her.
She just rattled on until she had gotten so furious, you know, that she said, you know what, I'll go to my grave before you'll ever know. I could be Lisa, I could be Wendy, I could be Debbie, I could be Monica, I could be anybody. And if my parents are still looking for me.
Monique registered with the Missing Persons Registry, put out posters with pictures from her childhood, and went on a multi-state search to no avail. She wrote a book and donated all proceeds to the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children and holds workshops in schools to teach kids how to protect themselves. The recent case of three abducted girls found alive in Cleveland brings her to tears of joy and sadness.
These women were in a house with windows that were completely covered. And I was free and still in captivity like that. You know, so it was like my life all over again. And I've been telling so many people that all missing kids aren't dead. You know, we are alive, we're here.
Now, Monique doesn't think her real family is still looking for her, but she still has some hope that her childhood pictures will be recognized someday. She says that the woman who claimed to be her mother is still alive, and she's working with law enforcement on her case. Reporting live in the newsroom, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.